Hey YouTube, it's Blackwing Volumes unboxing time again on the RixCanDoIt channel after this short intro. All right. Unboxing of the Blackwing, and I have not opened it up yet, see? So I have no idea of all the goodies that are in here, but I must bring out the patented X-Acto Wacko, and I'm going to start slicing this puppy up and getting it open. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Drum roll. All right. And what do we got here? Oh, this is interesting. Okay, there's a bottle in here with some black little beady things. Look at that. It's a record in a jar. How cool is that? A record in a jar. This jar contains enough vinyl pellets to press one 12-inch 33 1/3 RPM record. Now, depending on how old you are, you may not have ever heard of a 33 1/3 record. But back when I was a young kid, that was the standard album size vinyl record you play on a record player. And even today, I know there's been a big comeback to these records, these albums, vinyls, they call them. Big old fat. I hope it continues because it just has a sound that cannot be replicated on these digital CDs and whatnots and MP3s, and you know, it just kind of just changes the overall analog. Anyway, I'm no expert on music, but I am an expert on what I like to listen to, and I certainly do miss those old albums. I don't miss 8-track tapes so much. Used to get jammed in my player all the time back in the 70s, pulling tape out all the time. They were pretty cool when they worked, but you know, anyway, that's something different. Here we go, the Blackwing, and this is the 33 1/3. It has a matted black finish. It has a gloss black imprint. It has a matte black ferrule. It has a black eraser. And it has balanced graphite, which is my favorite, just like the pearl, balanced. Absolutely. And before I go rocking into that box right there, let's take a look at the tubular. That's right, the Blackwing tubular. And that is your collector piece here. That's in a tube. That is your 13th pencil. Has nothing to do with unlucky 13 or anything like that. Don't be superstitious now. But as you can see here, it has the little write down. Oh, come on, camera. Let's get with it. There we go. And it shows you 33 1/3. You know, when I heard that it was going to be called 33 1/3, but I wasn't told why, because I didn't want to know why. I want to be surprised. You know, I should have figured it out. I should have figured it out. But you know, it's been so many decades since I had anything to do with 33 1/3 albums, or 45s for that matter, that it just didn't click in my old cranial. So anyway, and then it kind of gives you the old what's with this focus thing here? All right, but anyway, there it is, September 2018, balanced graphite. In the tube to be saved so that 100 years from now they'll dig me up and dig these up and go, ooh, this is what they used to use as eating instruments. Okay, so much for the future. And now we're gonna go right into the actual pencils themselves. There's nothing else in the box. You know, I wish they'd throw some stickers. You know those stickers that they did in a couple of them? They should just make it standard. Make a sticker for every release. You know, I'm going to point that out when I direct them to my video. You guys watching, give us a sticker for every Blackwing volume you release, says the talking finger. All right, so moving on, let's open it up. And as usual, we have the really nice, solid, wallpapered, yep, there it is, traditional, trademark, I imagine, everything else, Blackwing wallpaper box. Then you have this vellum, which gives you the rundown of the volume 33 and a third, which also I imagine, let's see, well, no, it's not on the back. Oh, it'd be on the back of that, it'd be on the back of this box right there. There'd be the old rundown. But what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to take a look at this right now. And it says, in 1877, Thomas Edison invents the phonograph, a wax cylinder capable of recording and reproducing sound. Then in 1909, the first album is released. It is Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker Suite, pressed on four double-sided discs that resemble today's records. And then by 1930, the first 33 and 1/3 RPM 12-inch record is released by RCA Victor. That's the dog that's got its, like, sticking its face into the phonograph speaker. You know, today you wouldn't call it a speaker because it looks more like one of those trombone type of deals, but it was a speaker back then. And then in 1982, the first commercial compact disc is issued, marking what appeared to be the beginning of the end of the vinyl record. But that was not to be. Because in 2006, vinyl records hit their low point, only shipping 900,000 units worldwide. That's sad. Then in 2010, vinyl becomes the fastest growing music format for the first time since the sales data started being tracked in 1991. Yes, what I was saying. It's picked up. And in 2018, vinyl sales grow by double digits for the 10th straight year while CDs continue to decline. That's because CDs stink, if I say so myself, and I do, yeah. All right. Oh, nice. Let me do that again. Oh. Okay, now, first off, I have to say that I was not a big fan of the glossy black pencil. I think it was like the 56 or something. I'll have to kind of look it up. Yeah, let me look it up. It's the 24. Rick, get your number straight. There's 24, and this here was kind of a glossier black. I was not a big fan of that because you can't see anything on there. It's just all black. And of course, I'm gonna bring that pencil out. Here's volume 24. Let's check out the difference between these two here, shall we? Because I'm gonna show you what's really cool about that pencil. If you can't even see right there, see that right there? That's so cool. All right, let's get the 24. Okay, here is the 24. This is glossy black. Everything's glossy black. Black eraser. And you can't see anything. That's it. That's what turns that John Steinbeck on, is a solid black void in space. Then we have the new 33 and a third, which actually has cool style. Check it out. Check that out. Look at that. You have matted black with these glossy black rings, which I would think are probably tracks. At least that's what would come to my mind, would be like, hey, these must be like tracks, like on an album. I don't know. And then here, you have that nice glossy black writing. So it really kind of contrasts off of the matted black finish. And the ferrule is a matted black as opposed to what was the glossy black on this 24 here. And then, of course, you just have that same eraser on there. You know, nothing original there. But this black pencil is cool. That's cool. Matter of fact, I'd like to have a charger painted like that. Yeah. That is really nice. I'm going to sharpen that puppy up and write with it a little bit. All right. And there it is. Look at that. Oh, that incense cedar wood. That is high quality wood there, folks. And trust me, I sharpen a lot of pencils, and that is high quality. And here's another thing that I like about these pencils here. Look at this. If you sharpen it and you turn it all the way around like this, and you have relatively the same amount of lead exposed, do you know what that means? I'm waiting. Okay, I'll tell you. It means that the core, the lead core, is well centered along the shaft of this wood casing, as opposed to, but there you go. That is nice. That is a beautiful pencil to behold. That is a beautiful pencil to use. And I know what a balanced graphite pencil feels like, but hey, I'm here to share. So here we go. All right, this is the Blackwing. Oh, that writes so sweet. Blackwing Volume 33 1/3. Balanced graphite pencil. You know, I don't know how to translate an enjoyable writing experience on camera. I don't know how, but this balanced graphite, I just absolutely love it. It has got excellent tonal value. Look at how dark that is. And it's very smooth. It just glides like butter on the page. And when you're writing, the last thing you want to think about is the scratch of a pencil. Unless that's what you're into. But hey, let's just keep that between you and I, okay? Now, It is the same as my favorite standard Blackwing pencil, which is the Pearl. This has the balanced lead as well. So it's the balanced graphite. They should be the same. And this is what's on my desk. You can see it's getting, you know, it's getting smaller. And this here is the Blackwing. Yep. Pearl. So it's the same, feels the same. It's buttergraph. I'm going to trademark that, buttergraph. What do you think? Okay, so this 33 1/3 pencil, I have to say, is happy days again. I really do, because I was getting kind of depressed that a couple of the recent volumes that I received, like that rose colored one, wasn't my favorite one. Yeah, you know, people talk. But I was really hoping to be surprised with something that I can say, yeah, that would be so cool to have. This is a good looking, I mean, I know we all have different tastes. I get it. I watch the news, but just not CNN. I don't like CNN. But anyway, the thing is that this is a beautiful pencil. Even if it's all black, it's two kinds of black. It's gloss on matte, which really gives it a neat character. Has these interesting stripes here. It's really, really high quality. And it has this really buttery feeling balanced graphite, which just happened to be Moi's favorite graphite. So, I mean, what else can I say? This is an awesome pencil. And of course, not to break with tradition, I'm gonna read the back of this and say goodbye.
So, from their introduction in the late 1800s, analog records have withstood the advent of radio, the rise and fall of CDs and MP3s, and the dawn of streaming. Rather than be displaced by these more convenient ways of consuming music, the vinyl record has instead shifted from an object of convenience to one of connection. And it has thrived in the process. Just as the way we engage with pencils and notebooks is different from the way we interact with keyboards and touchscreens, the way we engage with records is different from the way we interact with digital music. From the rich, uncompressed sound to the LR and liner notes, records tell a story both physically and sonically. According to music icon Henry Rollins, of all the ways to listen to music, vinyl best represents what the musicians wanted you to hear. The vinyl experience not only creates a physical and emotional connection between music and people, it creates a connection between musicians and their fans. The Blackwing 33 and a third is a tribute to vinyl records. It features a matte black finish and matte black ferrule to go with its black imprint and black eraser. The gloss black foil banding near the grip was inspired by the grooves on a record.
So, awesome. The volume 33 and a third. Really cool Blackwing volume. Go get yourself some while they last, because they're going to go bye-bye. I guarantee these are gone. Hey, I hope you like this unboxing review. If so, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you in the next video. This is the shark coming, you know, at you while you're on the boat.